Kate to the rescue. Duchess comes to aid of boy, 10, who became ill waiting to see her. The Duchess of Cambridge came to the aid of a 10-year-old boy who became unwell after waiting 3 hours in the cold to see her today. She and Prince William were on a visit to Coventry when she spotted that Craig Skipper, a pupil at Corpus Christi Primary School in the city, felt poorly. Kate, 36, turned to one of her police protection officers for a sick bag. Carole Flynn, a learning mentor at the school, said, "Princess Kate came over and gave him a sick bag, our little Craig. I think he was a little bit overcome." In a pink coat by Mulberry, a maternity dress by Madderson, and £3,400 morganite and diamond cushion drop earrings by Kiki McDonough, the Duchess met Craig on a walkabout outside Coventry Cathedral. Ms. Flynn said, "He went quite pale. She came over to speak to him, and noticed he was not very well. She asked if he was okay. She bent down, and was concerned." The future queen then went over to talk to one of her police bodyguards, and came back with a brown paper bag of the type used by cafes for takeaway coffee and sandwiches. Ms. Flynn said, "It was lovely of her. She really took time with him. You can tell she is a mum, and has got that caring side." Fortunately, Craig didn't need the sick bag. Ms. Flynn said, "He is a little bit better now." Outside the cathedral, Kate got involved in some football banter and revealed that George, 4, and Charlotte, 2, have both got Aston Villa kits, the team their father supports. Taylor Mosley, 9, said, "I said to them that I'm a Villa fan, because I know William is a Villa fan. He said he wants Sam Johnson to be our goalkeeper forever." Brian Mulonby, also 9, said, "Kate told me that George and Charlotte love putting on Villa kits. I told her I am an Arsenal fan, so I don't really like Villa kits." Taylor added, "She said, I have to be loyal to my husband." Inside the cathedral, which was rebuilt after it was bombed in the war, and consecrated in 1962 in the presence of the Queen, they joined in Litany of Reconciliation, one of the themes promoted worldwide by the cathedral. In the cafe, which is run by a charity which helps the homeless and addicts, they were confronted by a spectacular array of cakes, including a princess one with a tiara and a Union Jack cake. They were baked by volunteers and addicts in various stages of recovery. William said that Charlotte would like the princess cake, and described the Union Jack one as very patriotic. He added, "You should be on Bake Off." In the cafe, which is run by the charity Beetle UK, Kate spoke to former addicts, including Kim Gardner, 44, who now runs Beetle's Women's Houses. She said, "I came from a broken home and was addicted to heroin for close to 11 years. I have been in prostitution, I have been in prisons." She said how amazing it was that you have changed your life. She said how they want to get to addicts earlier by doing more with families. Ms. Gardner, who lives in Birmingham, also revealed how the best planned royal visits can have slip-ups. She said, "We put almond milk on the table, because we had read that she had it." She said, "Don't believe everything you read, I don't even like almond milk." At the event, William also paid tribute to former England footballer Cyril Regis, who died on Sunday at the age of 59. Regis helped Coventry City win the FA Cup in 1987. Cafe manager Philip Goldbourne, who spoke to William, said, "We talked about Cyril Regis. He said he was an iconic figure for black footballers." He added, "He is an Aston Villa supporter. I gave him a bit of stick about that, being a Spurs fan.